You've invested in a lot of companies. One of your biggest wins is Facebook. Have you ever done a count? How many companies do you think you've invested in over the years?
Well, okay, so me personally, so Facebook, I was part of that team. I wasn't on the board, right? But so I would say if we just started with the ones that I personally led, it's probably around 40 or 50, where, you know, I
So
took a
that's a good
board seat or,
number.
yeah, maybe, yeah, that's probably about right. But then if you expand it into like my firm, whether that was Excel, Aspect, or Accrue, where I was, you know, a partner or managing partner, and we collectively decided to invest in a company like in Facebook, and in that case, obviously Jim Breyer took the board seat there. That would expand into, it would probably be 5 to 10x that, so in the hundreds.
So you've either led or been involved in investing in hundreds of companies. What do you look for in deciding whether to invest in a company?
So this is the part where market is important. So I tend to take a very thematic approach to investing. So identifying sort of markets, you know, like cybersecurity or like within consumer net vertical search, and then go and look at a lot of the companies. So the market piece is sort of a priori a little bit. And that's maybe 2/3 of the investment. Sometimes it's just like great entrepreneur comes in. It wasn't something I thought about before, but I was like, wow, that's awesome. I'm gonna make this investment. And of course, you need to make sure that the product, the technology, or the idea of it is differentiated. But at the end of the day, as the first institutional venture capital check, which is what the Series A is, I'm investing in people. And this is why I said before, to me, teams, it's all about the teams. And I do mean the teams, not just, you know, it's not just the solo founder. I mean, I think if you look at most of the great stories, right? Some of them is very well known, like with Google, like Larry and Sergey. But, you know, if you go back, you know, yes, Bill Gates, but also Paul Allen. I mean, most great, huge companies in Silicon Valley that have received venture backing have had, at the time of raising the Series A at least, there's more, even if it's just, usually there's more than one founder, but even if it's not just one founder, by that point, the founder has recruited some more people to join them in their mission, in their vision. And I think that is at the core.